all know what Midsummer Night's Dream is.
Everyone has either got a version of it in their head, or seen a version of it, or been in a version of it. And we've just been trying to challenge any of our assumptions.
Sometimes you watch the play, and yes, there is the light, fun, mischievous parts that like we all love, but actually there's an undertone we're not being afraid to explore.
There's been so many moments in rehearsals and been like, and then really looked at it and been like, Why are we laughing?
It's like this funny, whimsical thing.
Even if the audience are in a comedy, the characters are not.
Ella's not looking at any sort of preconceived ideas.
It's really exciting to get rid of that and go, no, we're going to look at this text and see what it is right now, today, not with all this like history slapped on top of it.
I'd love for it to be a situation where the audience, they leave like, wow, that's really challenged a lot of the preconceptions I had about that play.
Still gonna be funny.
It's got like talking donkeys.
Nature creeping through the set.
Fairies.
And the costumes are kind of wild.
Goblins. The costumes. Lovesick teenagers. Oh, like it's kind of got everything that you could possibly need in a story.
All played by a cast that beautifully represents a lovely slice of the world we live in.
And of all the plays that will speak to people, Midsummer Night's Dream is that capacious to be able to let everybody in.
This play can be an experience that we can all have connected with each other in the yard, exploring, breaking down those binaries of gender and human and magical and all of that, and just making it this one like incredible spectacle that everyone can share in that building.
Midsummer Night's Dream will be vibrant,
monstrous,
sexy,
provocative.
I hope they just have a blimmin' good time, because it's a very special building. And yeah, for a fiver, bon appetit.